The federal government said on Tuesday that China is becoming apprehensive about releasing loans to Nigeria following probes by the National Assembly on loans earlier released to Nigeria by the Asian nation. Although the government insisted that no nation could recolonize Nigeria as a result of Nigeria's indebtedness, it cautioned lawmakers not to hamper its ability to access international funds. The Minister of Transportation, Chibike Amaechi, and the Minister of Justice, the Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, said this in a live television program. Both ministers argued that Nigeria's sovereignty was not at risk in the country's loan agreements with China, as recently claimed by the National Assembly. The Minister of Transportation said the probe by the National Assembly had made the Chinese government to think that Nigeria was probing the loan agreements in order not to repay about $2 billion so far collected from China. And joining us now live on that matter is Sokonte Davis, who's a former director, Marine Operations. Good to have you. Good to have you.
Good morning, Amaka.
Good morning to you.
Good to have you too.
Yeah. All right, yeah. Let's go straight into the matter. Do you agree with the House of Representatives that the federal government did not cross its T's and dot its I's before taking the loans?
Straight away, it's unfortunate, I would say, what I'm saying, being a former member of the House itself, is that as far as I'm concerned, the federal government did all what it's supposed to do. And, you know, when the House Committee and protocols and agreements, broken agreements, came up, treaties, protocols, and agreement came up with this inquest. I actually tried to reach out to the chairman of the House Committee, Honorable Nicholas Osai, and asked him, does this committee not have lawyers who could easily explain what sovereign immunity means in an agreement? And secondly, I also did ask him that as the House dissolved the committee, the House Committee on AIDS, Loans, and Debt Management, because there are two committees like that. The Science Committee is essentially there to look at treaties and bilateral agreements and protocols that are going to be binding on Nigeria, not on commercial issues. Loans are an exclusive of another committee, which I said is AIDS, Loans and Debt Management. When the federal government wants to take loans, it sends a letter, a communication to the National Assembly. The National Assembly now sends that communication to the Committee on AIDS, Loans and Debt Management. That is the committee. Osai's own is pursuant of Section 12 of the Constitution, which is to deal with issues that require ratification. So there is nothing frightening that a nation will lose its sovereignty. Losing sovereignty is not easy. Sovereign immunity is a concept. Sovereign immunity is a concept which derived from a legislation in the United States of America. It's called Foreign Sovereign Immunity Act. And the purpose of that act is because countries go into transactions, commercial transactions. And when you go into commercial transactions, you cannot sue any country without its consent for any reason. And now you are taking loans from countries, from commercial entities. There should be a way for them to ensure that if you default, they can get their asset, they can get the payment for their assets, what they've invested. They're not coming to run your country. Their interest is their assets they've invested on. How do they get repayment? And that is why an overwhelming majority, almost every international transactions, on commercial transactions, on loans from commercial entities, a country is required to waive its sovereign immunity so that the defaulting entity can be sued and recovery of that loan can be made. It's not to take over the sovereignty of a nation. It's not to come and run a nation. Okay. It's a guarantee that this loan I am giving to you, you will pay back. And it is So in fact, it's a requirement for international best practices. So I do not know why this issue has come up, and that's why I did ask the chairman. He has not responded to my message. I called him, he didn't respond. I sent him a message, he didn't respond. I said, are there no lawyers in your committee? Because I know that a lot of times, in fact, almost every time, when we are having a public hearing or investigative hearing, lawyers are always there. They are consultants. We explain these things. And I'm sure if the lawyers and the consultants have done a proper job, this matter wouldn't have come up, because it's an unnecessary distraction. As far as I know, as a former legislator, and as far as I know about transactions, business transactions between sovereign nations and commercial entities.
Right. Now, some have castigated the Chinese of making a clandestine move to take Nigeria's sovereignty. And you have explained that the matter at stake is them assuring that they can recover their assets. Now, what do we do from here?
Exactly. From here, there's nothing we need to do. It is an unnecessary distraction. It was totally unnecessary. There was nothing to frighten any, because we do know what is happening in the international arena now. A lot of countries are uncomfortable of growing Chinese influence in developing nations, because China is giving loans to countries at very minimal rates. And most of these countries, that our development has been stunted by high rates. You know, a few years back, they had to write off our debts, because loans you are taking at exorbitant rates from commercial entities, from private borrowers, lenders, and so the country's resources are going into debt servicing. So now that the Chinese government has encouraged its commercial entities, its export and import banks, its commercial banks, to give out loans to developing countries, now some of those countries have exploited and colonized our economies through high rates of loans, are frightened. And we are aware of their campaign of colony, we are aware of their propaganda. And I think that, I'm not saying that National Assembly members are not part of the propaganda or the campaign, but I think that some members of National Assembly have not understood this propaganda and have cut into it. And when they see such things, they begin to run. Mm-hmm. A lot of the world has always been, and that is why I've discussed outside this elsewhere, that Nigeria is wise, because it is not taking these loans to establish some white elephant projects. It's not establishing this loan to even maybe set up recreational projects. It's for developmental, critical developmental infrastructure.
And that brings
you can
me
see
to
all the items. Excuse me?
Yeah, that brings me to my next question to you, because you are saying there that this is crucial. The question is this project worth all of this attention and all of this back and forth going on?
The loans secured by the federal government are for critical development infrastructure. Look at the rail sector. Because our rail sector was broken down, our roads couldn't sustain the pressure they were having. Because certain types of goods must not be transported by roads. If you transport them by roads, the roads will not last for long. They are only meant for rails, and rails are limited to specific areas, and they make things easier. They allow for the carriage of heavy tonnages. And so, look at the railways. The money is being invested in the railways, and we can Abuja-Kaduna rail line. We can see that the Lagos-Ibadan rail is getting completed. We can see that the Ajokuta-Takle-Wari rail line is being completed. And all these are critical national infrastructure, development infrastructure that we are hitherto absent, which in a great way stunted our development. Now, the federal government's policy that every rail line must terminate at seaport, and we have so many seaports. And you know that over 90% or 95% of our international trade is through the seaports. And since it's through the seaport, it's also necessary that our railroad lines to be properly developed and be modern. So what is happening right now? These loans are being taken to, one, create modern rail lines And two, to also rehabilitate the old ones so that things can be happening while the modernization of our rail lines is continuing. And so these are necessary things. There's one waiting for processing of boiled rice. Look at what has happened with pandemic and the issue of food. If there are no such facilities, who would have fed Nigerians? In this period, young people, countries are not exporting or exporting less food to other countries. But nobody knows what the pandemic would come about. So the loans taken, they are not for recurrent expenditure. In this context, once the government is pursuing, have been taken to develop critical infrastructure for national economic development. So I think that they are proper, I think that, that they have the capacity to pay off these loans. And you can see from the figures from the Minister of Finance and Debt Management Office that efforts have been made to repay these loans and that there have not been any issue of default. And that has given the Chinese government the confidence that they are going to pay them with all these distractions coming up. We're going to make them to be afraid. Put yourself in their shoes.
All right.
If you are giving loans to some people, if you are giving loans to some people, and some of your nationals are going to raise up issues, you'll be apprehensive.
Okay, that's where we're going to leave it. Thank you so very much, Sokonte Davis, for your time and bringing insights to the conversation. Do keep safe out there.
Thank you, Amaka. Thank you very much for your
time.